I got another spotting scope somewhere here if somebody wants to look through that, too. There's two side by side. This is slightly different.
There's another one.
I got that one on video.
There's just four of them. Look at this, three of them all together.
I got the third one popping.
There's one behind the chimney. One just squared up.
I got four of them. Major sighting here.
There's five. Another one just showed up.
They're
multiplying.
Whoa! Maybe somebody's setting up lights.
Did you see that?
No, those are in the sky.
The house too. There's one underneath the house too.
There's one behind that chimney. We need to go to Pecos.
I can't see how this works. How does this
Holy
work?
Holy
Oh, you got a
shit.
Have
you
seen
that
before?
No.
That's weird.
They're lined up in a pattern, man. There's geometry behind this.
Yeah. I can't even get this. I've never seen it. Look at that.
Man, this is...
What is this? Oh, there's three of them all lined up.
No,
four, Bill.
One,
you don't, Bill,
over here.
Over here,
come
there's
over
four.
Here. Come look.
Yeah, I see.
Over the top right now. I don't know, but I got it on tape.
They just appeared. They didn't even come
okay,
in.
I got them out.
What does it look like, Bill?
They just appeared. What do they look like in their camera?
They look like...
They look like there's three of them in the line.
What do they look like? Like this
sphere
before?
Yeah, they're spheres now.
Are they complete circles?
They just transformed into circles right now, right as you were talking. Now they're not spheres.
Well, see, the way we saw them.
Hey, Stephen Greer missed out, didn't he, Bill?
Have you guys seen this before?
Nope. This is a first for me.
Anything like it?
I have similar video of this from other people.
You just see little orange things. That's the way we were seeing them when you see them big.
You see a gyro.
They're big and they're moving and they have an eye to them.
Do you see an eye? Like a bullseye?
No.
Did you show them the tape already? Did you see the other tape?
Yeah.
See an eye?
Yeah.
Out of focus here?
I don't know if that's a video or
we got major hockey puck activity. I think the one on the left may split in half. It's.
See, it's drifting down.
It seemed like the one on the right split there for a minute.
How many is there? I got four.
Let me go look at the other side. Then they just started going.
No.
The other one faded away. The other one went left.
Behind a tree.
Four appeared so fast.
I got three lined up. Oh no, I forgot to hit the record button.
There's only three and they're going down now.
Have you hit it?
Yeah, I'm just kidding. Anybody got a still camera, 35 millimeter? Hey, look, the one in the middle's doing something. It's going out of alignment.
It's going out of alignment.
It's dropping.
The one on the left, did it drop off?
No, the one in the middle is dropping slightly, and it's the one on the right's blinking. No, that's because it's going to hit behind a tree now. They're definitely moving. No, one is went behind a tree or something.
Yeah.
The one on the right will be gone in a minute as soon as it goes behind something.
Get up close.
Yeah, let's go in a minute here. Okay, number two. We're down to one. It's winking out or something.
Figure this one out. There's a double. There's a third one. Hey, Sue? All right, you tell me what it is. Oh, what do we got? Hey, Sue!
Oh, my God.
time is about 10 o'clock, Sue?
Yes.
10 o'clock, March 13th, Thursday night.
Yes.
Isn't that weird? Look at that.
Terry est femme au foyer. Elle habite dans un autre quartier de la ville. Le 13 mars 1997, elle dînait dans son jardin avec une dizaine d'invités. À 20h, 2 heures avant l'apparition des lumières dans le ciel, tous affirment avoir assisté à un phénomène spectaculaire.
Il était aux environs de 8h, 8h15 cette nuit-là. Il faisait nuit. Tout à coup, l'un de mes invités a regardé en l'air. « Oh, qu'est-ce que c'est ?» Nous étions entourés d'arbres dans ce jardin et nous ne pouvions pas voir la forme de l'engin. Le devant, l'arrière et les côtés, c'était tellement grand.
C'était un objet, pas des lumières. Vous avez vu un objet avec ses bords et tout le reste.
Non, non, nous ne pouvions pas voir les bords parce qu'il était trop grand. On pouvait voir son mouvement. Il se déplaçait, il y avait un ciel rempli d'étoiles et tout d'un coup, vous ne pouviez plus voir les étoiles.
C'était un peu comme un blackout, il a caché la lumière.
Il a caché toute la vue du ciel, nous ne pouvions plus voir le ciel. C'était silencieux, absolument silencieux.
C'était un vaisseau comme un V, quelque chose comme ça. Je l'ai regardé et j'ai pensé que c'était étrange pour un avion de voler ainsi. Apparemment, il volait sud-sud-est. Il était totalement hors des couloirs de vol parce que les avions viennent de l'ouest.
Un témoin a dessiné l'objet volant en forme de V qu'il dit avoir vu.
Ils ont dit que c'était un objet énorme, silencieux, et ils étaient tous étonnés, stupéfaits et intimidés. Nous avons eu plus de 700 appels téléphoniques.
Tous les appels vont raconter la même histoire ?
Oui, la même histoire.
Une nuit, plusieurs personnes ont ainsi vu un objet aéroporté survoler la vallée de Phoenix. Deux d'entre elles, un pilote de ligne commerciale et sa femme, rentraient chez eux après avoir dîné à l'extérieur. Il était environ 20h30.
Ma femme m'a demandé ce que pouvaient bien être ces lumières. Elle a arrêté la voiture, je suis sorti et j'ai regardé en l'air. Les lumières s'approchaient et nous ont survolé. Et là j'ai dit, ce ne sont en tout cas pas des chasseurs.
Le couple a préféré garder l'anonymat, mais ce sont des témoins de confiance. Vétéran du Vietnam, il a 30 ans d'expérience dans le domaine des avions, aussi bien civil que militaire.
On est sorti de la voiture et on a éteint le moteur. Et là, on a réalisé que l'engin était silencieux. Ça m'a donné la chair de poule. Et puis, il était si grand. Il prenait toute la largeur du ciel quand il est passé au-dessus de nos têtes. Je me suis demandé ce que ça pouvait bien être. Ça m'a fait froid dans le dos, j'ai eu peur.
L'objet de forme triangulaire et de la taille de plusieurs terrains de football passe lentement au-dessus d'eux. Et ils l'observent comme envoûté. Puis l'OVNI disparaît au loin.
Il était juste au-dessus de ma tête, et j'ai vu que ce n'était pas un avion. Il ne faisait aucun bruit, et il allait trop lentement. J'ai réalisé que j'ignorais complètement ce que c'était.
Thank you. Wow, that is so cool.
Well, you got your pyramid, dude.
Kind of. Dad, can I do the news?
Yeah.
Who got the same spot? Egypt came out in 3. They're like half of a pyramid.
Wow, look at that.
They just turned into 3. There's like, it's been like a wire ever since.
Where
we've
are
seen
you?
Like,
look at that!
I know.
Wow!
Looks like 6.
Careful.
In my eyes.
I gotta clean my eyes because I can't believe this.
I know. It's
Dad,
3. What?
Open that up.
Oh, huh? You can't see it right there.
I know. Yeah. It looks like
not?
6.
It's
looks
not.
Like 6.
It's not.
3.
It's 3, Josh.
Two bundles and together.
Where's that security dude?
Oh!
Wow!
Wait, you want me to be able to go get him?
No, that's okay.
Wait until he comes over here, right?
Yeah. Wow! I knew we were gonna have a good sighting tonight. I just felt it.
Dad, do you think it could disappear? Leave your camera on when it disappears.
Yeah.
When they come on, you might see the solid.
There they go.
Dad, do you see the solid?
No.
I see something solid.
Holy cow! Did you see that?
Dad,
it's so bright.
Dude, they're moving.
I don't see anything, Josh.
I see something moving really slowly.
I don't know, it's very interesting, whatever that was.
Another strange sighting has a lot of people talking in Arizona. It's not the first time mysterious lights have been spotted hovering the night sky there, but this time we have pictures. And joining us now is iReporter Brad Drenning, who witnessed the whole thing and took some incredible pictures, and it's the most viewed video ever on our user-generated community website, iReport.com. Hi, Brad. Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. How are you today?
Hi, I'm great. Thank you. First off, thank you so much for taking the pictures and sharing them with us. I want you to tell us, how did it all go down? Just tell us about what happened last night.
My family and I were watching television last evening just after dinner. My son, David Drenning, one of his friends, Kyle, called and he said, hey, there's some lights outside. You need to go check them out. And we walked outside and we looked up and it was just kind of, you know, total amazement. We looked at it for quite a while. I ran in. I'm a big CNN watcher. Ran in. I grabbed my camera and we started filming, you know, right away. So it was just amazing. It's hard to even describe, you know, but they just sat there. They didn't move. They stayed in one position as far as in the same area.
Uh-huh.
And then they just started making different formations. So it was very hard to explain, but very exciting all at the same time. And I think you can hear that from the video.
Right. We could hear your children talking in the background, too. Could you hear any types of noises coming from these lights?
We couldn't hear any noises. They were very far away. I mean, there was a plane in the video that you can see. There was a plane, but it was probably 30 or 40,000 feet mm-hmm. lower than what we were able to. The lights were way up there. I don't know how to explain that.
So when you say they were in formation, okay, we're watching some video now. I don't know if you could see it, but they kind of move apart and then they kind of come back together. What did you think when you saw this?
Well, like I say, at first they were in a straight line before we got the camera, and then they started moving into different formations. I've actually am working with some of your folks there in Atlanta right now. I'm downloading another almost 11 minutes of video from the same situation there. And they moved in different formations, trapezoid, square, kind of a W, and then it moved into a diamond. So it was very specific type formations, and then one by one they started to blink, and one would take off, and then, you know, very systematically, and then the fourth and final one stayed up there for about another 4 or 5 minutes on its own.
Mm-hmm. Well, of course, you probably heard the military came out today and said they had no type of aircraft in the area or were doing any exercises there. I'm sure you heard that. Have you lived in Phoenix very long?
We've been in Phoenix for about 8 years.
Okay, have you ever seen anything like this? Because, you know, a lot of people have said they have seen things such as this before.
I have never witnessed anything like this before. We've heard all the different, you know, situations and stories, if you will. But this was the first time we actually witnessed something of this nature.
Has anybody from the military tried to contact you to get your video and see what it is?
Actually, no. No one from the military has contacted me. There's been several different media outlets, if you will, that have been contacting me all morning. But nothing from the military as of yet.
Now, if you had to say what it is, would you say it's a UFO?
You know what? I know that, in my opinion...
That's a tough question. I don't mean to put you on the spot.
No, it's okay. In my opinion, there's no way it could be some type of flare. It had to be something other because, like I say, it was they stayed in one area, they didn't drift off, and they made very specific formations. So it was something that's very hard to explain. A UFO... You know,
right.
Very, very interesting.
Yeah, it's almost one of those things you definitely have to see to believe, and
exactly.
That's what we're doing right now through your video, and we really appreciate you sharing that story with us. Again, Brad Drenning from Phoenix, Arizona, one of our iReporters, and hey, if you see anything else, please be sure to send it again. Thank you for joining us.
I sure will. Thank you.